Just want to introduce myself first. My name's Alan Nell. I'm the regional fundraiser for the Firefighters Charity. And really, that's why we're here tonight, to hopefully raise lots of money for the Firefighters Charity. The great news tonight is that every single penny of your entry fee goes directly to the beneficiaries of the charity. So all the money collected tonight and from ticket sales goes to support firefighters and their families. Just going to give you a bit of an update on what the charity is. Some of you will be friends and family of the people singing tonight. Some of you might be new to the Firefighters Charity. The Firefighters Charity was set up during the Second World War to support families who'd lost firefighters during the blitzes on cities around Britain. We skip forward about 73 years to the current day, and still we're here now supporting firefighters and staff and their family. The ways we do this is we have state-of-the-art facilities around Britain. If a firefighter or a member of staff or a member of the family suffers an illness or an injury in the line of work or any injury really, we can get them to the centres and we get them fixed and we get them back to do the jobs they love doing, looking after their communities and looking after us. Inherently, the jobs that they do are quite dangerous jobs. So when people like us have an incident and we're running away from an incident, these are the men and women who are putting on the kit to go in and save us. But accidents do happen. It's not always in the press. Not everyone knows about it, but accidents do happen. So if anyone suffers a bad physical injury, they'll go to a recovery centre. The nearest one to us is a Jubilee House up in Cumbria. And there we give them all the best treatment we can. Physiotherapy, we've got hydro recovery pools, we've got all sorts of kit to make them fit and healthy again. Also, we've invested heavily in the last couple of years with the mental health side of things. Obviously, firefighters do see some pretty grim sights, and we give them the option to go away to a lovely part of the Lake District and just talk and get over the mental scars as well as the physical scars. We also go and look after our retirement section as well, so if they need any access around the houses or anything like that, we do that. But pretty much, we look after every single firefighter, every member of staff in the fire service, and their partners and their kids as well. So it's a massive network. It costs £8 million a year to support the charity and keep it running. So nights like this where you're coming supported really does make a massive difference to the charity. So thanks very much for your support tonight. I'm going to pass you on to the Chief Fire Officer of Cheshire now, Paul Hancock, and he's going to introduce the choirs. Thank you.
Good evening. Excellent. I've had a response from the audience. It's difficult to see how many there are in the audience because the lights don't particularly help. But can I, on behalf of Cheshire Fire Authority and indeed Cheshire Fire and Rescue Service and the Firefighters Charity, extend a very warm welcome to you all here this evening to the first concert that the Cheshire Fire Choir has held, and they are joined with a number of friends who you will see in your programme. I know this is a very special night for the individuals within the choir. They've all been on an incredible and fascinating journey over these last 2 years since the Gareth Malone choir programme on the BBC. They've worked hard, they've developed a very, very strong bond, and I have no doubts whatsoever that you will enjoy this evening's repertoire by Cheshire Fire Choir, but again, ably supported by our friends who join them on stage. I'd also like to just thank you all for not just supporting this evening's event, but all the contributions and the cost of the tickets go towards the fantastic Firefighters Charity. And it's really important that we continue to support that charity for the beneficiaries of the charity, because you will all be aware that firefighting is a very hazardous and dangerous occupation, and something that I've been very, very proud of during my 32 years service, and I've no doubt whatsoever that anybody else in the fire service shares that immense proud and that solidarity amongst the firefighting occupation. So without further ado, again, a very, very warm welcome. Thank you for supporting this evening's concert, and I'll now hand over to Cheshire Fire Choir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Save it for later. Thank you very much, everybody. Just so you all know, my name's Phil. I'm the chairman of the Cheshire Fire Choir. So again, for me, thank you. Who was that? Thank you so much for coming, everybody. That song, in case you didn't know, was by The Killers. It's a song called All These Things. I almost forgot. And this next song is called Stand By Me.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Cheshire Fire and Rescue Service Choir. Please give it up for them. Your two soloists for that piece were Michelle Truscott. She has recently got married. That's her second name, Michelle Truscott. She was the soprano soloist. And your tenor soloist was Matt Lloyd. You'll be hearing a lot more from this wonderful choir throughout the evening. My name is Rory Edwards. I'm the MD of it. Thank you very much, one person. That's fantastic. I'm the very proud MD of this choir. I first got to know the choir before they got to know each other. We were formed 3 years ago on the programme Sing While You Work, which probably most of you know about, which was led by Gareth Malone. I was the pianist on that programme, so I sat there on the very first day during the auditions when these people who had never sung in their lives before decided to rock up and, you know, have a go at it. And I was there throughout the whole of the filming process, and I became their MD just after that. And we've had 3 years together since that filming, without the support of any of the film companies or anything like that. It's just been through the service. I'm immensely proud of the progression they've come on, and you're going to hear more of that tonight. Before we go any further, it's a very important other person in this choir who is very much part of the family, part of the team, who I'm now going to introduce to you in a very musical way. Her name was Wendy Dolby until just a couple of weeks ago. She got married, and she's now called Wendy Nugent. She has been with us since the filming finished, so also for 3 years. As well as being an amazing accompanist and part of the team, she's just the most amazing classical pianist, and you're going to hear something from her right now. This is by Rachmaninoff. I really hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Wendy Nugent. Oh, are you coming back from a... Here she is again. So, she's quite good, isn't she? So, this is an evening with Cheshire Fire and Rescue Service Choir and Friends. You've heard one of our friends, who's also part of the choir, that's Wendy. Our next set of guests are conducted by a man called Ian Chesworth, and we know Ian because he worked with the Cheshire Fire Choir during the filming when we were first going. So most of the choir are very familiar with him. This wonderful group of people assembling behind me here are called the Manchester Airport Choir. They're conducted by Ian Chesworth. Please go absolutely crazy for them. Welcome them to the stage. Manchester Airport Choir, Ian Chesworth.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, that was Fly Me to the Moon, and of course we had to get some reference to flying in, didn't we, being the airport choir. The next piece that we're going to sing, in fact, before we do that, I should thank Rory and the Fire Choir for inviting us. We are delighted to join you this evening. And just on Fly Me to the Moon, the next piece we actually learnt for the inaugural flight of between Manchester and Beijing, believe it or not, Hainan Airlines put the first flight into Manchester this year, and we learned this piece, and it's a Chinese folk song called Jasmine Flower. Hua Lin, let me get it right. Mu Li Hua, sorry, I'll never get it right. So this is Jasmine Flower.
Thank you.
finish this set, we're going to end up with a piece by Coldplay. And I'm sure you know the song Viva La Vida. And there's a bit at the end of it where we kind of, the choir goes, whoa, and I think you can join in that bit if you want to. Do you fancy joining in? Yeah, I'll turn around and I'll give you a nod and join in that a bit. So this is to finish off our first set, Viva La Vida.
Manchester Airport Choir and Ian Chesworth, everyone. So, just before we continue, there's just something I wanted to clear up with you all. You've probably noticed that Manchester are looking lovely, lovely outfits that they're wearing. The Cheshire Fire Choir, we're wearing these lovely polo t-shirts with our sponsors on the arms. Just check those out, make sure you get a good look at them. Now, I know you've all been thinking it, so I just wanted to clear it up. Yes, this is a woman's fit t-shirt. I just had to clear the air before we carried on, just in case some of you were thinking, it was the only one that was left, so I've got the short straw. Long story, but that's all you need to know. We're changing outfits for the second half, so thank you. Oh, there we go. It's the same guy who applauded me earlier. I mean, I've been paying him, but... so we continue with lovely heckling and everything. Friday night, why not? We're continuing now, and I'm really excited to introduce our next guest to you. He is a man who is making a very big name for himself and who is very likely to be a big name in the future. I've had the pleasure to tour with this man earlier this year. We went around a few different theatres. We even supported Sir Tom Jones, which was quite a nice experience. He is an opera singer. He's a good friend of mine, and he's now a friend of the choirs as well. Would you please welcome, for the first time tonight, he's going to come back a bit later as well, please go absolutely wild for Mr. Matt Bond, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. fight, I'll die. Just watch me die. See how I die. See how I die. That is probably my all-time favourite song from musical theatre. That is Gethsemane from Jesus Christ Superstar. One of the all-time greats of musical theatre. Give it up again for Rory Edwards on piano. Rory has been so, so supportive to me over the last year. I owe a lot to him. Anyway, coming back on our fantastic Cheshire Fire Service Choir. Give it up for them again. I've never been to Warrington. I haven't. Yes, I am coming back. Thank you. What a wonderful hall. What a beautiful, beautiful hall. Great, great, great performing space. Anyway, singing you into the interval, give it up again for the Cheshire Fire Service Choir.
Your bridge of troubled water when you're you're weary, feeling small, when tears are in your eyes, I will dry them all. I'm on your side. Oh, when times get rough,
Mr. Steve Bud Flanagan. title. And me. The next song we're going to sing actually has quite a poignant time for me. In 2013, in August, while the choir made their first performance in front of the judges in Sing While You Work, I was actually in Ghana helping our cadets, our fire cadets, build their fifth school. So, the next song that we're going to sing, as I said, is very dear to my heart. And our soloist in this will be Mr. Dan Selby. And Mrs. Michelle Truscott, she's just got married. So ladies and gentlemen, our next song is Africa.
Thank you. evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Louise. I sing in the alto section of the choir. The next song that we're going to do is Total Praise. And I've been asked to tell you that this is a song that normally only choirs over 100 sing. But because Cheshire Fire and Rescue Service Choir likes to take on a challenge, we decided that we were going to try it. And also, it's Rory's favourite gospel song, so no pressure. Just to let you know, after this song is an interval for 20 minutes, which is the perfect amount of time to pop yourselves outside and buy our single. Thank you.